basic structure. So starting off, what you're basically looking at is, as Trevor Moore had mentioned earlier, one of the good benefits about CRM and NAB is the fact that you're moving on to newer technologies. You're getting off of those older, non-integrated technologies and moving on to ones that will work on handheld devices, tablets, things like that, as well as fully integrating. And, of course, Mike's shown us some of that already. So what we normally recommend is basically one server, one physical server most of our customers require, and you're going to run on that the SQL Server databases, SharePoint, SSRS, the BI tools, all those business intelligence items, all integrated into SQL Server. You'll also have to be running what we call virtual server. That just comes with the natural virtual server license that Windows operating system comes with, so there's no additional cost for running this virtual server. And that's going to run the NAV, and if you've got CRM, it'll run the NAV and CRM services as well. And your existing workstations will basically just connect into NAV and CRM using that technology. If you've got remote workstations, laptops, handheld devices, and so on, they'll access the items, again, through IFD, which is internet-facing deployment. So that's a way of sharing out the CRM. There's also CRM apps for tablets and iPads. And as Trevor Moore demonstrated earlier, there's also, of course, the web-based NAV tools. So all of this is providing you both land-based in-house as well as remote-based access. We've also added in this diagram an optional terminal server for those like the remote users to access the system through terminal services. So what is it you're looking at? A basic off-the-shelf server for all intent purposes. It's going to have quad-core 64-bit architecture. So basic, if you can buy it, that will suffice it. Most cases, our customers go between 32 and 64 gigs of RAM on the server, plus or minus depending on how many users you have, but that's about an average. Again, standard sort of storage space, terabyte, nothing super duper there. That's more than enough space. One thing to note is that it will be requiring Windows Server 2012 or 2012 R2. I'll talk a bit more about that in the next screen or two. Again, 1,000 gigabit per second card, standard sort of stuff you'd get in a server. And this physical server would also be running, as mentioned earlier, a virtual server to run the NAV services and CRM services if you've got that. So let's talk a bit about the SQL Server side. You have several options depending on what you want to look at. Right now, with NAV 2015, NAV 2015 supports SQL Server 2012. It still supports 2008 R2, if you've got that. And it also supports SQL 2014. So NAV 2015 basically supports the three main versions of SQL Server that you can get. That being said, if you wanted to go with CRM 2013 does not support the newer version of SQL, which is the 2014 version. So if you're going with NAV 2013, you'd either go with SQL 2008 or 2012. And if you're looking at CRM 2015 is going to be available in February of this coming year. So CRM 2015 is just around the corner, and it'll be all the things that Mike's showed you, that's going to be part of that. So if you're looking at CRM 2015, then SQL Server 2008 will not be supported in that. So if you're looking at purchasing now, your best bet for SQL Server is the 2012 or the 2012 R2 versions. That would be one that would give you options for all the different items integrated. Also in terms of Office for running things like the BI cubes, as well as JET reports, which is an Excel add-in for NAV so that you can directly draw and refresh data from NAV. Those would require either Office 2010 or, of course, 2013 Office 365. So the newer versions of Office also are supported for those BI cubes. In terms of the workstations, what is it you need? Again, sort of a standard workstation. We generally recommend 4 gigs of RAM. You can get by with 1 to 2, of course, and things will run fine. But if you have heavier users, 4 gigs of RAM is probably better for you. And again, 64-bit system. Office, again, with 2013 and 2010, same idea. You need Office to run the BI cubes, the CRM Outlook integration, so that's where you access CRM directly through Outlook. for the nav, import and export functions to and from Excel. Again, you'd want the Office products. So basically the stuff that you can get today is going to be more than sufficient. In terms of the workstation operating system, you have some options here. The key thing to note is the newer versions, so for example, the remote versions, Windows 8 and 8.1, ones that are now working on tablets and so on, those are all supported in NAV 2015, CRM 2013, and in the 2015 version of CRM that's coming in February. So basically, you're good if you've got Windows 7, 8, 8.1, all those features will work. If you have a Vista machine, then really the only thing you can run on that is CRM 2013, but most people I know have Vista automatically go to Windows 7 anyways, and XP has, you know, its days are over, so we've moved on past the XP. It just doesn't integrate well. Another thing to note for the tablet and iPad users out there, the newer version of NAV, so NAV 2015, supports the most recent versions of Android, so that's 4.4.3, as well as iOS 7.1, so that's that iPad operating system. So newer versions are supported under NAV 2015. Current version of CRM does support Android versions, 4.4.3, and iOS as well, and 2015 as well. Now with 2015 and CRM, there's been no official release for what the Android and iOS versions supported are. So for those particular versions, they may, you know, as Android releases a new version out, in the next month or so, that will likely be supported by CRM, but they just haven't given an official release. So basically what you're looking at is a sort of a standard server, nothing super duper, with the newer operating systems on it. Again, something if you can buy it in the store, it's going to basically work, and yet it gives you all of the features and the functions that Trevor's shown you earlier and that Mike's gone through. The other thing I wanted to take a look at is the visual to NAV conversion process. Mike's going to talk a bit about that process afterwards, but I thought I would give you a quick little rundown on what's involved. So we've been looking at NAV, and you've seen some of the great features in NAV, and NAV being one of the three options you have for the visual users out there. You might want to know, well, how do we get our visual system into NAV? So we'll give you a quick overview here. Basically, you start off with a new database server. That's going to be the one that's going to run your new system. And as we saw, it's going to run SQL Server with the SSRS and SharePoint in there. So again, all of the features, the integration with the business intelligence tools, the integration of document management, both from NAV and CRM into SharePoint, all of that is in there. And so that's what will be on the new database server. We'll also have a new application server. And the application server is a virtual server that runs on the database server, and that virtual server runs the NAV and CRM software. Then once we have that set up on in your site, we go ahead and we actually convert or migrate the data from your visual database into NAV. Mike will talk a bit about this further, but it's basically it's a push-button process. We've got it narrowed down to a sort of a click and data comes over. So we basically load up your NAV system and move on to the next step. And the next step is to then have PCs access NAV and CRM, and they can access the software without having to uninstall Visual. So all your existing workstations that currently run Visual, we would also load the NAV client on that. And so you can do testing on the very machines that you're going to be using in the live environment. You can test NAV and compare it and see how it works and get an opportunity to train and learn on it. You can also take advantage of those BI cubes and tweak your reports and get everything set up the way you want to. And once you're happy with that and you're ready, we go to the go live. And again, the go live is basically just remigrating your visual data. So we're refreshing, if you will, the NAV database with your new visual database. So it really is that simple, sort of down to a science basically, and as I said, it's sort of a push button structure. And the idea is similar to it's actually less involved in many ways than some visual upgrades we do. So it is definitely a viable option, and as Jim mentioned earlier, the migrating over to NAB, Microsoft is basically funding it, so it's 50% of the price. So it's a huge opportunity there if you're looking at moving into the current generation of hardware and software with running all the various mobile devices and integration.